Our previous videos showed you how to log in, how to prompt, and how to modify your Edge toolbars to use Copilot. This video, we're going to take Copilot a little further and explore a new feature, as well as how to save and export your conversations. As you know, once you're logged in and you check for that protective signal in the upper right corner, all of the conversations and the prompts that you have within Copilot are not automatically saved. In fact, you can start a conversation and it will generate that content for you. You're able to preview it on screen, but there may be certain circumstances in which you're wanting to keep and to save that information. So let me show you real quickly how you can save that content that you've generated. Let's say this is exactly what you are looking for. Your prompt has yielded perfect results. You can navigate to the bottom here and copy and paste it into a document, or you have the option of exporting, clicking that arrow down. You'll see that it currently offers you three ways to export that prompt as a Word doc, a PDF, or text. Depending on how you're wanting to keep and utilize that, you are able to select one of those options, because each time you log in, it's going to clear that information. So when you select a new topic or sign in, all of those conversations that you have are no longer saved there. So in that instance that there is content you've generated you want to keep, be sure to either copy or export that data. Now, let's look at a wonderful tool that recently was incorporated into Copilot. This may or may not show for you yet, as it's something that just recently was tested, removed, and then brought back into Copilot for its official launch. So if you don't see it within the next couple of weeks, definitely refresh, clear your cache, and you should have it available. Down in the prompt section, you'll see there's an option to add a file. This is a rather new feature that allows you to upload existing documents. As you're aware, Copilot is generative AI, which means it's creating content from content that it's pulling on the web, content that exists and generating it in a new form that's never been seen. Just as it works on gathering that data and information by scouring websites, it can scour those documents that you already have on file. So let's take a look at a couple scenarios. Let's say that you have a PDF document. Now, there's options that you might have quite lengthy PDF documents. For our purposes, we'll put in a quick prompt here, and we'll attach a file that we already have ready. The file that I'm uploading is a PDF of all of the different roles in Microsoft webinars. So it goes line by line of what you can do in a webinar. So you'll see my prompt says, from this file, do Microsoft webinar co-organizers have the ability to mute participants? You'll note that I'm prompting it to review the data from the file that I've attached, making it very clear and concise that that's what you're wanting it to pull from, not from other sources. So it'll take just a moment and it's going to scan all of the data within that PDF and help get that one particular answer that you're looking for, so that you're not having to scan through pages of a PDF to understand an answer to just one question that you might have. So we asked, do co-organizers have the ability to mute attendees? It was able to scan that document and see that yes, you absolutely are. So this AI-powered PDF summarization and analysis can be very beneficial when you're dealing with large documents, whether you're dealing with invoices or receipts, complex technical documents, or any type of registrations. These long PDFs with robust knowledge and information, but maybe you only need a small aspect or detail from that. Copilot will help you extract that relevant information. let's give it a little bit more challenging prompt from some more nuanced piece of information. So I'm going to pull up a PDF document of my department's org chart. This includes everyone in the department, not just me. So I'm going to prompt it a little bit of a trick question because I want to use this as an example of how it's reading information as well as how it's reading what you prompt. So I asked, does Amanda Pritchard work for desktop support? Here's the trick. Desktop support is within my larger overarching department, but it's not a role that I have. Okay, so I jumped ahead so that I could have a few examples of prompts to show you some of the nuances that I was mentioning just about being able to adjust your prompt to what you're trying to get. Copilot is learning and is generating that AI response. If you do not get the response that you think you should, check your sources. That is our responsibility for training and programming this new tool to ensure that we are getting information that is relevant and what we wanted. So I'll show you this final prompt and we'll go backwards. But here I asked, does Amanda Pritchard work in OIT according to this document? I attached our org chart. It's able to read through that, find my name, find my title, find my department, and be able to sync those together. Now, here's the trick. Each time you reprompt it using that file upload, you need to include that file. So here I did state, where does Amanda Pritchard work in OIT, when I didn't clarify in that document. So you can see it's pulling from the web, it's pulling from information, various sources. That's not me. And thankfully, I'm self-aware to know that that's not me. But what you have to do when you're looking at your prompts is determine where this information is coming from. So if it is coming from a source, such as Wikipedia, that I know is not relevant to my prompt, you can eliminate that information as incorrect or inadequate. And as you can see, sometimes it does take a couple of prompts in order to generate the right response to the question that you're looking for. So if it doesn't give it to you right away, just as you have a conversation with a coworker or a colleague, ask the question again in a different way. Be clear, be concise, be straightforward, and assess those results to make sure it's generating what you're looking for. Copilot, in addition to adding those PDFs, adding those images, you're able to add Excel files or CSV files, and that will allow you to do some detailed data extraction and analysis. If you upload an Excel file, Copilot can extract data from it. As long as you have your columns labeled and the information clearly sorted and organized, you are able to use this feature in Copilot to analyze that data, generate summaries, or perform calculations. And yes, I know you can do this in Excel as well. However, if you have a lot of robust data and you're wanting to get a quick answer or you're not wanting to filter and sort, Copilot offers a quick solution for you. It can help you compute those totals, averages, or visualize trends. So what I'm going to do is just give you a simple example. We're going to start a new topic and add in a file of a meeting attendance list that I have. This is from a recent meeting, and we're going to ask it, based on this document, did TMOC attend this meeting? Again, we want to always reference that you're trying to pull your data from the document you attach, not just from websites as it does its searching. So it'll take it just a moment and it's searching through the data, those columns, everything that I have labeled to determine what is available and how it's going to be able to sort that information. After it searches through, and depending on the size of the file, it could take substantial time. Once it filters through, it's going to give you an answer based on the data in that spreadsheet. So you can see here that TMOC did attend the meeting. It's also pulling data from an additional column that I have based on that meeting time. So it's showing that he attended at 12:34 p.m. You can continue on with additional prompts. It's going to give you some ideas of further data that you can extract. But it's truly up to you based on the information that you're wanting to gather and the information within that document. So I encourage you to upload some files, look through what prompts that you can write, determine how you want to extract data or quickly summarize information And you can also upload files and identify trends or new analytics, but it's a very quick way to assess that information without having to drill deeply into that data for that analysis. Hope this has been helpful. Check out some of our other videos on Microsoft Copilot.